I'm over here with Jack Catterall at El Gato.
El Gato.
Now, at home they call me El Gato, but it's because I eat loads of chocolate gatos. Where's the name come from, Jack? El Gato?
El Gato. So I had a friend, still a close friend of mine, come to the gym, and he used to call me the cat, or the cat's here. Catterall, the cat. And then he started coming to the gym going, El Gato. I said, what are you going on about? He's going, El Gato, the cat. So I don't know how he discovered it, but then it kind of just stuck from there. I think this was like after my first fight, and he was in the gym quite regularly, and he was going, El Gato, and it stuck. I thought, you know what, I like that, Jack the Cat.
Yeah, it's a good name, good name.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge Michael Alexander scores it 118 to 111. Judge Bob Williams scores it 115 to 114. And Judge John Keane scores it 116 to 113. All in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And new British Super Lightweight Champion, Jack El Gato.
Catterall wins the belt. The celebrations are profound. They're noisy. Huge disappointment for Tyrone Nurse, who was trying to get the belt outright. But we have that new champion from Chorley, Jack Catterall.
Thanks for inviting us over today to your house. It's good to see you.
Really. Oh, it's good to catch up.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I've been meaning to for a while, haven't we? But I've always wanted to sort of just do a proper interview with you, really, and get to know you and, you know, what you're about. And like all boxers, you're a good guy, polite, well mannered, and all that. But I've always thought there's a real sort of steely side to you. And
what's that mean, steely?
I don't know. I mean, you're a boxer, so you need that steely style. But
of course, yeah.
That steely kind of aura about you. But you know, I just want to get to know really Jack and what you're about and what makes you tick.
Of course, yeah.
Let's start from the beginning, really. How did you get into boxing, and what was it as a kid that, you know, suggested that you was going to go on to be British champion, but be a boxer in general?
Right, so as a kid, obviously, like all kids, I had a lot of energy, and I tried a few different mixed martial arts. I'd done karate, I'd done judo for a couple of years, I did wrestling, and then I was nine and a half at the time, and Mum said, well, why don't you try the boxing club? I was getting bored of these other combat sports. It was like, my mum would tell you, she's like, always telling, I want to do this, I want to jump out of a plane. I had too much energy. And then she goes, try the boxing club, went down there. He says, how old are you? It's nine and a half. She said, you've got to be 10. So we're gutted. And I think my older brother at the time, he's 3 years older, I think to wind me up a little bit, he went and joined. And I couldn't go for 6 months. But by the time I started, he'd already fired it off. So when I was 10, I went down there, I trained for a full year, loved it, and then my first fight at Rivington Barn, lost the fight, and was absolutely gutted, thought no way I'd give a whole year to this, and then I lost it, and he got me another fight probably about 3 weeks later, and I stopped the kid with a body shot, and I was over the moon, and then that was it really. I used to finish school, and the boxing club's a mile from my mum's house, so it was just finish school, get my gym bag, have some food, and straight to the gym, loved it.
Well, Jack, here we are, where it all started for you, Chorley Boxing Club here in your hometown. You said there you've spent many a time sat on that wall waiting for the club to open.
Yeah, it's a nice trip down memory lane, and lovely day to be here as well. I used to sit on this wall waiting for Reece to come down the road to open up. Probably spent days of my life sat here waiting for the gym to open.
It's a very special place for you. It's where you built your character as a young lad and introduced you to boxing. A great hub for kids like you. And,
of course,
you know,
it was. Like I said before, I think half the kids in this town have been through this door and done that same warm-up all the lads are doing now. Do I mean, nothing's changed for the last, as I know, 20 years. But for me, it was brilliant come down here. I think it instilled that discipline in me. Very strict is Reece, which I think is brilliant. From a young kid, from 11, it instilled that discipline and politeness and get your manners. You know, like greeting everybody walking through the door, making sure you wipe your feet, and like No, it's really good. It did me a world of good. And likewise, hopefully, the kids that are in there now and the kids that have been in the past, it's done the same for them.
Mm-hmm. There's a lot of history behind the club as well, and we're going to speak to Reece and we'll find out a little bit about that as well, and we'll do something. So let's go in and have
let's
a look.
Let's go
Jack.
In and have a look.
Here they are, the old routines, Jack.
Back in, back to base. Trip down memory lane.
Yeah. So the typical warm-up on the night, you walk in the door, as I'm doing all the exercises first.
Yeah, I think they've had the same warm-up routine for the last 110 years, so, I mean, if you get an exercise wrong, you get 10 press-ups, and there's got to be 30 exercises in the warm-ups. You can imagine the amount of press-ups we had to do when we got them wrong.
Brings back memories.
It does.
It's great to come down though, isn't it, and see the kids. I mean, you coming down as British champion and bringing your belt and all that, you know, it's a great incentive to them.
Of course it is. And it's nice to come back down here. It's like, I think it grounds you. You come back, sometimes I come down, do a little workout, help the kids, and obviously, they're all young kids in this club, so it's brilliant just to be able to come down and show them the belt. They might not even understand what the belt is, but when they see a big shiny belt, they think, no way, and I tell them, like, look, I was only the same, and I look at half the kids and I think, you're better than I was, so they can definitely achieve it.
Obviously, they see you on the telly as well, and, you know, it's great, Ed, to have you in here. And like you said, if you're from the area, and if you can do it, they can do it. You know, you give them a chance to aim and achieve.
If I can come down here and inspire one kid, help one kid stay in the gym, job done, I think, because what it's done for me is massive, and credit to Reece, really. He doesn't get as much credit as he deserves, but over the years, he's helped that many kids and families by instilling discipline and getting people fit. Even like a life coach, really, just helping people, talking to people, so he's done a good job for the community.
Show us around a little bit then, Jack. Show us some of your favourite bags and where you've...
Gotta come over here. You know what you're in for when you get it. Welcome to hell.
What's this carpet thing? Tell me all that.
And as many of my mates will know, the dead dog. I think it's got sand in it. Might even have a dead dog in it. You get this on a Thursday night, you'd have to drag it around the ring. Caused some serious pain over the years.
You drag it around the ring like an exercise thing?
Yeah, right? So your legs, you just walk around the ring a bit, dragging it as many times as you can. You get some legs. That's
change. One, two, up, rotate.
Tell you this, then I was in Tenerife training in March. I was out running. I seen him, but I couldn't stop. I was at the back anyway. I thought, no way, that's bigger.
Tenerife just recently.
Yeah.
But no way. It was him. Confirmed.
Unbelievable, that.
Small world, yeah.
Fantastic.
You enjoy it? We got some nice weather.
Change the angle. Head and shoulders on the moon.
Reece, it's great to have Jack down here. Look, can see the kids are doing
absolutely
a little bit.
Tremendous. Makes the kids day, it really is. You know, I'm really pleased for them. And it's lovely to see that the lads are putting something back into the game.
Absolutely.
With the kids.
It's where it all began for him, and he knows where it, you know, his feet on the ground. Knows
I couldn't get rid of him when he was 10. I just couldn't get rid of him. I had to throw him out to the gym. Honestly, I had to make him. First in. And last one out.
Did you know he had it?
Oh, I could tell, yeah. He was so dedicated. So I was once asked on Radio Lancashire, what is the main thing? And I said, dedication. So what do you mean? I said, well, 95% dedication, that they are constantly turning up. The other 5%, you can train them, you can get them to box, and then you can see what natural talent they've got, and then you can start equalising the dedication with the actual techniques and everything. You know. You could tell he was going to make it when he said he was going to go professional. He knew then that he would really make it the big time. You know,
we
always said that.
You and the rest of the town and everyone else very proud of him.
Very proud of him. Oh, very proud of him. As I've been at a place this afternoon with all the little kids, and he said, "Who knows any boxers? Please, sir, Jack Catterall. Jack Catterall, 165 of them." And I would say, one in every five were telling me, "Oh, have you known Jack Catterall?" Yeah. Or they know of him. Absolutely love him.
Well, Judge, slip my hand after that.
Jackson here tonight, he's been down, you know, coming down, it's great morale boost for everybody.
Especially for the younger lads, because obviously, even though he doesn't probably realise himself, a lot of lads were in the change rooms chatting, they're always talking about how Jack's been doing, how Jack's been doing well, how they want to get up to that level that where he is, and he's becoming a real role model and inspiration for the younger lads here.
And it gives them an impetus, doesn't it, to say, look, well, Jack came in at 10 years old, he lives around the corner.
Exactly. He's a local and he always bobs in and keeps, you know, asks how everyone is, always asks about the coaches. He is a real lad. He's not the sort of person who's let the fame get to him. He's always stuck as a local lad and really humble. And I think that's what appeals to a lot of the lads as well, that he's still helping the community.
And there's been some great boxers come through this club, hasn't there? And there's one in this tonight, Jack Catterall. How proud are you, Jack? How well he's done for the town and for the club, I'm sure you're very, very proud of what he's achieved.
Yeah, he's making Chorley get bigger, I guess.
One, two, double jab. One, two, hook. One, two, hook. Nice.
Change over. You guys. And do you want to follow in his footsteps and become a pro boxer yourself?
Yeah. I want to become a pro, yeah.
What's it like having Jack Catterall here?
That's amazing, because it came down some girl, got to have a picture with his belt. Especially he's boxed out of this club as well. Well, it's amazing really, because when he's coming round on the bags, and he's been in that position before, and then he's all like telling us different things and to do, and then when he's here, it's just astonishing really, because he would have been in my position about when he were my age, and now look where he is now.
How proud are you of what he's achieved? How proud are you of him?
Yeah, very, very proud as well. And you've got to look at Reece as well, pushing him constantly, all the time. And yeah, he's done really well, and hopefully more belts to come.
Ursha, where's your hair gone? Where's all your hair gone?
Over.
Over the years, I was here from a 10-year-old right until 16, 17, so I spent a lot of time down here with Reece and all the other coaches. So, and it's nice, me and Ershad used to spar for years back when we was younger, so it's nice just to come down and see Ershad again, helping all the kids out and looking at all the young lads and girls that are training and hopefully getting them fights.
Ershad, you've already explained what a vital community pillar this place is, and like you said, and Reece, and it's something that has been a big influence on your life too.
Yeah, definitely. One of the things that we talk when we talk about boxing, we think of self-discipline. This is where a lot of us, me in particular, got my self-discipline. It teaches you to work hard, and that nothing in life comes easy. This is the hardest place that you could actually learn that, but it gives you such a great stepping stone when you're actually getting older and starting a career for yourself.
And you know, there's a call in the community for it. It's proved that for many, many, you know, decades.
100%.
And Jack as well has proved that, you know, you can go on and if you want to pursue it, you can make a career out of it. It's giving you, you know, they want it, they've got a goal there, and there's no one better role model there than Jack Catterall.
I mean, I went to Jack's house a few times when we were younger, and I remember seeing posters of all the great boxers. So he was obsessed with boxing from the day I met him, and it was an obsession. So everyone knew that he was going to be great, and the coaching is brilliant. If I, like, you know, obviously I'm being a little bit biased, but the coaches are phenomenal. They've dedicated their lives to this sport, and you can see in Jack, for what, 10 to 16 years old, he was here, and that was, again, just that stepping stone to being who he is now. Mm-hmm. Obviously, the amount of effort that he's put in himself, and the coaching that has gotten him there as well.
To get where you get, the British champion at the moment, world ambitions, but East is where the building blocks began for you.
Of course, like I put a picture on my Instagram before, it's a trip down memory lane. Nothing's changed. Look, the old ropes, I've only got three ropes on there. I don't think there's a boxing club in the country that has three ropes on the ring. No real canvas, do you know what I mean? I don't even know how old Reece is now. I think he's like 306, but he's dedicated all his life to this sport for me and for generations before me, and now this generation. So it's amazing, really. And like we said earlier, you have to be disciplined and give a lot to the sport to achieve from it. But again, these coaches, four nights a week, three are Urshad now putting back in the community, helping them kids and dedicating their time for nothing. Obviously, these kids are coming down here, they're all doing it for free just to help the community and keep making it a better place.
And Urshad, you box for the club.
I did, yeah.
And now you come down and help out when you can.
Yeah.
You're on bobbing like Jack, when you can, keeping it. Great to do that.
I'm down a few nights a week. Given that, a few hours a week, it's nothing really. And like I said, if the amount of hours and years these guys have given to us, it's only right for us to give something back. And we get self-satisfaction. The development of these young kids is such an important thing, and they might not get that anywhere else. So it's good to be a part of that. It's bigger than just a boxing club. You learn how to live life. A lot of people who I've spoken to have associated becoming a man through this club. So it is a big deal.
From what I've seen and what Jack's told me as well, it's a real family. It's like when you come here and you join a family, and it's but it's hard to break away from them.
Of course, half the people in this town have been through this door, and I've trained here, and a lot of people, the sport's not for everybody obviously, but people come down here and it teaches them that discipline, and then you're speaking to older generations older than me, they've been down here, it's taught them that discipline. Yeah, it's brilliant, I think.
And as we say now, still doing it and put everyone on it. Let's just talk about Reece while he's padding. I mean, he's a special guy, and he means an awful lot to you too. But just what kind of a character is he, and how much of an influence in your lives has he been?
Yeah, of course. Ever since I walked through the door at 10 years old, Reece was the first person that I met. Don't think he gets to too many of the shows anymore, but when I was younger, I used to travel all over the country with Reece. I remember running up the hills up Rivington, me and Urshad, he'd come pick us up before school when we had the championships, put us in the car, and the pump in his arm, sprint, used to be going running. So he's given so much to the sport for, I say, a little reward really, but for him it would be big, because he's seen people born and achieve things and better themselves. So it's massive. Reece has been here, and I couldn't even tell you how many people in the community that know him and have said how positive things about him. Of course, it's a boxing gym, you've got to be disciplined. It's not going to be your friend whilst you're in the gym, but again, outside of the gym, I see him quite regularly now. It's nice to catch up with him.
I think he is tough. He has to be tough.
Tough love.
Yeah, it is. That's what it is. It's tough love. Yeah, I don't want to say too much. No, he's very tough, but you have to be like that. If you want to be successful in this game, you have to have that. And if you want to instill that discipline into the lads, you have to be tough. But the second somebody starts showing the fruits of all that labour, the amount of respect that he shows is unrivaled. Nobody will give you that sort of respect and put you on like a pedestal, because you've taken all the grief that he's given you and you've turned it into something, and you've developed, and that's all that you can do. Work hard and you'll get somewhere with it. Like I said, I don't know how many years Reece has been here. I think it's about 60 years.
248 years.
It's been a lot. And nobody can say that they've given, that many years. I've been coming a couple of years. It's nothing. It really is nothing. But these guys, they've given their lives.
Voluntary as well.
Voluntarily, yeah. Uh-huh. I mean, you can't respect them enough. Yeah. Obviously, we're a little town compared to all these cities that have got 5 or 6 clubs, and they seem a lot more active, but we're kind of like away from that, really. This is a small club in a sense, but it's nice, obviously. I don't even know if Reece has ever done an interview before, so it's nice to obviously come down here and show people what goes on here. And although we're away from the cities and where all them big fancy gyms are, it's still happening here and they're still producing fighters here.
Bare
bones. Really, you don't need all the fancy equipment and all that sort of stuff. You just need hard work and dedication. If you've got that, then you know, you're going to get somewhere.
And you two went to school together, boxed together.
We did,
studying, advising the next generation.
You've got to do your bit, like, try and put back in for the kids. And like I said, a couple of kids are fighting tomorrow night, so I know Urshad will have them right in the right place, and hopefully they get them wins and keep putting the boxing club and Chorley on the map.
So Reece, this is where it all began for Jack. Do you remember the day you walked in that door?
Oh, do I remember it? From day one, he wanted to join in and do everything that everybody else was doing. He just wanted to push all the time. He could tell straight away that this lad is going to start working and doing everything you ask him. He listened and he did exactly what you told him. And he was constantly coming up saying, can I do this? I want to do this. How do you do this? Am I doing this right? All the time, which is what you want. You want them to ask questions. Why do I do it like this? Why do I do it like that? Why do I have to stand left foot forward or right foot forward? He's sorry, Paul, isn't he? Apologise. Yeah, right foot forward instead of where the others are left footed, you know. So because you're left handed, you need your right hand to throw the jabs, and your big left hand at the back to throw the knockout punches. Mm. Oh, right. And of course we had Howard Morgan here training at the time. As I said, 12 stone 10, big Caribbean lad. And him and Jack were on famously. They really did, they sparred together. It sounds daft that when he was only weighing 5 stone and Howard was 12 stone 10, but he gave Howard all the trouble he could handle. He had to, being so tall, you know, because he was over 6 foot, was Howard. And it was wonderful just watching them, it really was. He got a lot of benefit out of it, because Howard made number 4 in the country, you know, in the top seniors, he really did. Went to Denmark, and again, I always tell the lads, they're only as good as the sparring partners. So in other words, you've as lot, can take as much credit out of a lad achieving as the lad himself. He was always here on time before I got here. He used to just help me with putting the bags up, taking them down, having to turn them upside down to bounce them and alter all the padding inside. He'd help me to move the chairs. Anything I asked for, he just wanted to get so involved all the time. Plus his training as well, you know. First here, last out, all the time, you know. He just loved it, and even though he said, take it easy, he didn't want to take it easy. He just wanted to keep working. And if he saw the bigger boys working hard, he wanted to do just the same. He'd stand next to the good lads and try and do exactly the same as they were doing. He wanted to be like them all the time. Absolutely wonderful, definitely without a doubt, one of my favourites. He's such a lovely lad, honestly. And he has never changed. That's the big things I like about Jack. He has never altered at all. And the fact that he comes down to the gym and helps when I ask him to do, bring his Lonsdale belt, and he'll help with the coaching. In fact, if he's wanted, can't do enough. He said, any time you want me, just give me a ring and I'll be down. And he keeps to his word. Mm. Does.
So to you it was no surprise, and how proud are you to see him go on to achieve so much as a professional?
Oh, very proud, very, very proud. It makes you realise that what you've put into them has helped them. I know the professional coaching is slightly different, it really is, you know, but there's an awful lot of Jack when we watch him on the television of the Chorley Amateur Boxing Club in him, still there, you know. That dedication, knowing to keep going no matter what. And he knows it's all about landing more punches than his opponent, which is what Jack does. and long may it reign. And I'm hoping and praying he can come away with the Lonsdale belt to be his own possession, because it's the most valued belt in the world. I know they have these WBOs, WBCs, but all those guys, I've heard them on the television and on in videos, they wish they had a Lonsdale belt. And there's only the Brits can get one of those, the Immaculate. It's Immaculate. I'm so proud of Jack, I really am.
Just looked at you then, I thought, have I grown? But I've stood on a platform. Yeah, you always just have to punch up at him.
So you're having a spa tonight for old time's sake?
Oh, I don't know about that. I've actually had a long day. Are you ready though?
No,
I'm not ready. I'm not for that though.
Great old dog, no. Great
shape. Leave that for another day. You too, brother.
From you, Chingy.
That's it, keep it going. Good on.